My apologies, guys. The first video froze and I didn't realize I was moving too many knobs, apparently. So in this video, I'm going to show you how to automate inside of FL Studio. Let's hop straight into it. So automating is pretty unique in FL in that you can move the automation around as if it's a pattern or an idea. So what are some things you can automate? Firstly, we can automate tempo. We can automate things within a synth. We can automate Omnisphere. We can automate image line plugin. So let's load up Serum because other people use Serum. Let's open up Serum. Now in Serum, let's say we want to automate things like a low pass filter, for example, and add some expression to the sound. Okay, what we can do is simply, let's play some notes, let's record. Okay, so not the greatest note, I meant to hit the half step. Okay, so now we have our notes. Let's say we want to record this filter. Let's hit record, notes and automation, and just move this filter. Knob, cut off, knob. Okay, now if we go back and I go to the playlist view, you can actually see now our pattern has this little thing in the background, an image. That's me moving the knob over time. Now in real life, you can move your knobs with your fingers and play as you're playing a synth. So you can create this really unique expression. And you can kind of do the same thing in a DAW, except you're using your mouse. Or if you have a more advanced MIDI controller, you can use that to control that as well. So that's what that color in the background is. So let's say you want to automate even more stuff. You can move stuff around. Click this drop down arrow, go to Browse Parameters, and it should highlight whatever you have highlighted. Okay, so it says Filter Resonance right here. You can right click and create an automation clip, or you can link it to a controller. If you want to use your MIDI controller, you could just link it to controller. If you do, hit auto detect and move a knob that you want to control that specific sound. So now I'm going to go in and just record automation, notes on automation, and turn up the resonance manually. Okay, so now they'll both move over time. So if you look at both these knobs, they're moving at different rates. Okay, and you'll see two different lines within the patterns here, okay? So that's how you can automate multiple things pretty simply in FL Studio. I like doing this for effect plugins, for different things to make them more unique. So for example, if we send this to the mixer, I'll just give you guys an idea. We can open up Fruity Delay 3. We can turn down the dry level, turn down feedback, turn down delay time, and we can mess with this time modulation in real time. Let's record notes on automation and just move this around. Actually, I forgot to turn up the time knob. Let's do that again. Okay, and now you can go back and hit record. It's already on notes on automation. You can also mess with this knob here, the time knob. Okay, so now both these will move over time and create a unique sound. Now you have a really unique chorus sound. And you'll see all these stacking up within the pattern here. So let's say you want to automate the tempo. This one's a little more tricky because with the tempo, you have to copy the value. So firstly, I start at the destination tempo. Let's say we want to end at 120. Let's right click. Okay. And then we need to copy this value and then go back to your starting value, 140. Now let's right click, create an automation clip. The reason I did that is because now I can right click this node on the right and hit V to paste, and then right click this first node, hit C to copy. So now you can go in and do manual. You can reset it back to where it started. Okay. So you can right click and reset. That's very important because if you don't reset, your BPM is going to be some weird BPM. You can read the value in the top left. As you see, FL Studio only gives you percentages. So it's not very clear what the tempo is at a specific time. But as you can see up top, the tempo is slowing down. Okay, so you can automate reverb. You can do a bunch of different things. I think I automated too many things last video and it just froze the video. So I'll show you image line plugins that you can automate, which is all of them. But again, you can mess with Flex, any image line plugin. Now inside of image line plugins, the difference is that I can just go straight to the parameter, right click and create an automation clip. Whereas if I'm using a third party plugin, I actually have to go in and move the knob myself, or go in and click this drop down and go to browse parameters and figure out which parameter I want to control. So whatever you move gets highlighted. So if you want to move and find a specific parameter, see if it's automatable, you can move it and it should pop up over here. And then you right click, create an automation clip. That's a third party plugin. Now with the image line plugins, you can go straight inside the actual plugin and automate something. So if I load up a piano, for example, and let's just copy the notes. Let me make sure the video is still good because I think last time it froze up on us. Okay, so let's copy this and paste. Okay, so let's say you want to automate maybe the cutoff. Okay, so you can right click and create an automation clip directly from inside the plugin. And that's the main difference with image line plugins versus third-party plugins. Okay, so you can automate literally almost everything. Now there's one more plugin I'm going to show you before this video potentially freezes, is Omnisphere. This could have froze the last video. So in Omnisphere, it's a little bit different because you can't just right click and automate something, and you also can't just go to the drop down and automate something. So in Omnisphere, it's just a little bit different. You click in the top left and you'll look in the browse parameters and you'll notice it just says level 1, level 2, level 3, level 4, all the way through 8. So you can't really automate anything by default. You have to actually tell Omnisphere what you want to automate. So let's pick out a random sound. Let's just click on random. Pretty interesting sound. Let's copy the notes, paste them in. Okay, so let's say you want to automate the arpeggio. Let's go to the arpeggio and let's mess with the speed knob. So firstly, we have to right click and enable host automation. And as you see on the left side, it appears a new automation here. It says one arp speed. So now I can go in and actually just hit the record button, hit notes and automation and move this knob, or I can right click over here in the browser and create an automation clip that way. But I'd rather just do it with my mouse. Okay, so now when I hit record and hit stop and play, you'll see the speed knob of Omnisphere move around. So that's how you can take your melodies and your sound designing to a whole different level, is through automation. Sometimes you don't need new sounds, you just need the sound to move and express like a human voice would, or like a real instrument would. I'm gonna cap this video here because I don't want this to freeze again. Thank you everybody for letting me know the video froze. My apologies. Go to busyworksbeats.com/FL Studio if you wanna learn more about FL Studio. Subscribe if you're new. Peace.